So I had time to cool off a little bit and basically take a step back and think about my own advice, take my own advice, eat my own dog food, so to speak. So to go back to the policy, then I had to determine that basically I was falling into my own trap. I've been telling you that once you get to confining the desktop, that, well, basically you get all to see all these AVC denials, and you tend to just want to make things work quick, and then you tend to make the wrong decisions. And that's basically what I did here, with these rules here. This is basically not this I shouldn't have done that. And so basically I will just undo this. Basically, when you start and it's with confining any application, you start by just looking at the AVC denials and determine where what programs get executed, and then basically take care of domain transitions first before you go any further, because domain transitions will affect the policy, will change the policy. So that's basically what we should do first, and that's a lot of boring work to do, but and that's probably also why I probably didn't do it in the first place. I thought maybe somehow I didn't take my own advice, and so but that's really the only way to take care of it. Of this stuff is to basically do that. So I'll just go. I'm just going to do that, and basically, I'm going to basically I remove the rules, and I'm basically going to put the system into a permissive mode, and I'm going to log in, and then I'm going to just see what AVC denials will be there with regard to domain transitions. So I'm just logging out here. Log out. And then I'll log in as the my login user. User. And then I'm just going to see AVC denials. My actually. And this is not right. So it's in permissive mode, so it should just work. Yeah, there are AVC denials. Of course, there are AVC denials. So let's just have a look at our search, and just 1944. See what's happening. How to allow, and you'll see this very a lot of AVC denials. And then less. There's plenty AVC denials here. So there are some rules that I can already, well, I'm not going to do that either, but I'm just going to look at stuff that gets executed right now. So I'm just going to grep for execute. And then run that through. Actually, I'm just going to less that. So that I can basically see the first execute. So here, for example, the login user, which is basically accessing itself, and that's proper because we told access into actually domain transition to the login user. So that's right. It's actually running the admin console type. So what we're basically going to do now is what we actually also tried to do before. It's basically create a type for that, for console type command, and just allow it to basically execute console type. And basically for all these commands here, we're going to have to create types for them. So we need to basically think carefully about how we should implement that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use SESearch, and then let's just use S and then domain, and then file, and then actually file type, yeah, file type, and then grep for execute. That's a lot. Less. Now, looking through this, let's just make that application exact type. Not sure if that even exists. And we could use as itself info. Yeah, right. So now basically we're let's just grab application exact type. So basically what we can see here is that every user on the system can run application executable files. So let's have a look at the application executable file. Application executable file. So that's in the applications module, which is in the applications here. In the applications, this one here. So basically, it assigns the type attribute to the application type, type. And then core command executable file. So let's look at the core command executable file. Core commands. And yeah, mess. Core command executable file. And basically, that it says it's a file type and then exact type. And then let's also see. There's no rules, visible rules for exact types. And then domain. And let's see what we have here. Nothing out of the ordinary. Let's look at this. So basically what we're going to do is give all these types that are currently generic and that need to be run by the user, give that an application exec type attribute. Use the application executable file. Actually, yeah. Yeah, we should just basically we'll use let's see how we're going to do that. We're going to use raw policy, of course. So basically we'll assign, let's have a look at exec type, see if we can narrow it down a little bit. And yeah, that we can narrow that probably down. No, we can't. Damn. So basically, we need to make these types, application executable types. And then stuff gets real messy, but that's the way we have to fucking deal with it. So don't panic, just start working. It's a lot of work, it's not nice work, but we need to do it. So execute less and just start getting it over with. User bin console type, we need to basically take care of that. Give that a I wish I had two screens open, or two connections, so that I don't have to. So we're going to do the following. Console type. Type console type T. And then basically I'm just going to require some stuff. Require, and then we only have to do that once. Exec type. Type. Exec type. And application exec type, and these are attributes, actually not types. I call this just various applications. So, type attribute, console type, and it's console type exactly. Console type exactly, and it's a file type. And then just make it exec type and application exec type. Exec type and application exec type. And then basically I need to take care of entry point. But we'll do that later. So we'll save and exit this, yes. And then go to the file context file and just add it then in there. And then system U, object R, and then console type exec T. Alright, done. Back to the out search. So we took care of console type right here. This is also console type. Here we have the dbus daemon running user lib exec im settings daemon. So we need to take care of this one as well. And this is actually a daemon, so we actually need to type transition on this one. So and it's just a lot of work, and this is going to make the policy huge. But you have to, if you want to do it, you have to go through this. There's no way out. So we're going to take care of this just the same way as hostname, except that hostname use this. So I am settings daemon. I am settings daemon. So in set DL, I'll try to keep it as simple as possible. So this we don't have to require anymore. Neither do we have to require these. We don't have to require these as well. But instead we need to basically type msetd exec t, and then just basically assign these type attributes. So imsetd, and here we have that imsetd domain, and then we have this stuff imsetd, and again. This basically is what we're going to have to set up for a lot of stuff. The boring part. And yep, this can be removed. But instead, it's not actually the user transitioning, it's actually the user dbus domain. Dbus domain. this should probably get us started. So now I need to take care of the transition. So we need to basically add a file context here. System U, object R, ink set day, D, exact D. And there we have that. Next. So we have dbus running f user mount. So user bin f user mount. We're going to, I'll take care of this one first. I think that was it. And then go to the type enforcement file and just basically copy this stuff over here. Except that we don't have to create a type for the executable file. Require type user mount t exactly. And we don't need this because that's already taken care of, I bet. And then I'm just going to do f user mount. And the same, it's also executed by dbus. This is going to have some effect on the system. As a whole. But long type, and I should avoid long types. Okay, so in theory that should also take care of that. Next. So we took care of fuse amount. So here we have SSH agent exactly. So we need to do the same. Do the same SSH agent. And actually we can remove the context for fuse amount, of course, because it's already labeled. This boring work. Also not right. Keep it simple. I'm trying. But this one is not executed by Dbus. It's just mandatory that you do this first properly. And then you can see how huge the policy can become. Bugs that the mistakes that you can make. Because here on top, I already see I made a mistake. Okay. SSH agents. On to the next. Okay, here we have the text relocation stuff. Basically, we have here where we allow libraries, and let's just assume that executing libraries is for graphical stuff only. So that's basically if enabled, then we'll leave it at that for now. Save and exit. You might also want to So here we have Debus Daemon. And this is basically a simple can exec. So this is basically a simple can exec. Oops, can exec. Debus policy. Debus here. And then just basically allow my login user dbusdt dbusd exact and then this stuff file and then this stuff, but also a no trans. File execute no trans, and that means that dbusd needs to be also an entry point. My login user dbusdt. Okay. Seems right. Let's see if this stuff even builds at the moment. Nope. SSH. Oh yeah, my login user SSH agent 498. Where are MI 498? Built back to the boring work. So and then we have at spy bus launch, but nothing actually executed of actually. So here we have user bin pulse audio exactly, and we want to transition there as well. But it's GNOME session. So basically, we need to really be careful here, because actually, to be honest, it's not showing all ABC denials. It's skipping stuff. I can just see that. So let's just see if 2016 really takes patience. 2016, and we still have. So I'll wait for 2017. We just really need to make sure that, but it's probably due to the settings of of RDD, probably that it basically skips stuff. So we shouldn't we should make sure that we don't do transitions where they are not where they shouldn't happen. clean. Except that stupid FDA agent. For some reason. It doesn't kill. Okay, so now we're going to have to go to this stuff again. Grab execute. Only look for execute right now. And we're still getting that. Oh shit, I forgot to fucking restore combat. See, there's so much stuff to think about that you'll forget stuff. It's just getting real nasty. And I also probably have a bug there as well. And I probably didn't even load this policy. Messy. Somehow, I just always panic when you're doing this complex. When you have so many AVC denials and you know that so much is still to come, that it just gets you out of focus. Some reason. Okay, now it's set. Now I'll just need to log out again. And 2020. This, if there's no execute, then it's fine with me. 2020. Okay. And then just log in again. Execute no trans, why is that? I thought I did a transition. So let's see how this looks right now. We have the spice VA agent. Divas runs fine here. And all these IAM settings, the domain transition did not happen. And it's probably also because we didn't take care of our contacts. Yes. So many. So let's have a look at console type. Oh yeah, actually we should probably just transition on console type. Although it's probably not very useful, should probably do it anyway. And console type is actually run not by divs. Console type. Console type. Console type, and yep. Console type. Console type. And it's actually not run by dbus, it's just run by a normal user, I think. Pretty sure. Step by step. Take ages this. You just have to accept that and go along with it. Console type is a reasonable, simple domain. Basically, we need to go through this whole list. Once we got that done and out of the way, then we should be able to at least log in. So 2027. there. We did the restore con. Oh, and basically I need to take care of some dead processes. PS aux, grab my login. So we have this kill all you my login. Somehow these processes keep hanging. So let's see whether this gets us. So we at least got rid of some stuff. So we want to basically take care of this one, and it's run by login user itself. So copy FC first. System U. Object R. And then XRDB. XFT. Zero. XRDB. Basically, copy this, and then below XRDB, and then just go over this stuff again. XRDB. XRDB. And so on and so on. You want to confine those because we just want to try and not run as little binty as possible. And this gives us some more flexibility. It also costs a lot, of course, because this comes with a price. It's overhead. But yeah, I guess it's worth it. Gives me flexibility. And then XRDB, of course, here as well. I always keep getting that. I'll just do it per domain, because else I forget stuff. It's RDB. Need to find some rhythm, some rhythm, I guess. So we start on this path. Oops. We start on and then log out. Then kill all the remaining processes. Whoops. Get messy. 2033. Now we have XDM also trying to run it. So we need to take care of that. And this, we don't need to take care of that. But we do not need to take care of this one here, xmod map, user bin xmod map. It's basically the same same idea. And I'll need to make a light. Because it's getting dark, I can't see my keyboard. And if I can't see my keyboard, then I'm making all kinds of stupid mistakes. So, basically the same stuff. It's also just run by a user. Yeah, it's also run by a user. And we don't need to do this one, the MCPP, I guess. Probably. So, T go all the way below and just do the same. X mod map. Then just go there. This is kind of like that, yeah, it's just boring work. A lot of work and it's boring. But it has to be done. Oops. So we need to restore conlet path after we did that. After we compiled and installed it. And then just go through the whole list. Basically, you can't just go ahead and do it all. You really need to do it step by step, unless you can find a way to make audit actually log everything. These are XDM actually trying to execute them. So we need to, well, we can basically just so I'll just in the meanwhile it's 39 and then it's clean. Now log in again. And there we go again. Drill, same drill. Gonna take ages. We're not there by a long shot. And now we have basically XRDB. This is old stuff. This actually debug launch. Transition is already happening. Debus launch. We're just going to execute this. What the heck? Let's just take care of that as well. Let's just transition there as well. Debus launch. Debus launch. lunch. Let's just copy that over, copy paste it. It's a little bit quicker. Then actually, this might actually change the whole scenario. Oops. This might actually change the whole scenario. That and the same drill again. Restore config log out. Take the time. Yep, take the time right there. Kill all these remaining processes. We out search, we're on 45, but we're not clean, so here we have more stuff. Basically execute, then my xdm dm xdm te audit to allow r and then get that too. My xdm pp and load that again. Seems xdm also runs it, and that's basically how we do. And we're now at 46. We're clean. Let's run it. It's taking its time. So here we have, yeah, XRDB is running the MCCP, and here we have Dbus launch actually executing Dbus exec. And then you can see that now all of a sudden the scenario has changed. Because now everything what used to run at the in the Dbus the user Dbus domain is now actually running in the Dbus lines domain. So we need to go to the Dbus policy and change some stuff. So with the the transition here is basically Dbus lines. I'll just copy this over for making it a little bit easier. Yeah. So that the transition happens back again. Damn. That should do that. Take the little steps at a time. Little steps. Don't get ahead of yourself. No use. Doesn't help anyone. Kill the processes and see the outserts. We're at 50 right now. We're clear, and let's just do it again. Boring work, but it has to be done. Someone has to do it. See if we're now back to Dbus. Yeah, we're back. Yeah, we're back in the actual state. So let's just, for fun, have a look, see if something changed in our my login user. So how does it look now? So we're getting somewhere here. We have a few domains right now. We have Dbus lines, we have Dbus, and we have IAM settings daemon. And basically we're going to have to go through all these. So you can imagine how much work that is. But you see, we're basically only taking the, we're doing it step by step, daemon by daemon, or process by process. We're not going to basically work through all these at once, because like I said, audit doesn't print all the AVC denials, so you might get you might end up with some wrong stuff if you're getting ahead of yourself. So we're taking it one step at a time. You might sometimes skip one or two steps, but that's it. So I'm going to take a break right now, but at least we're on the right track again, I think. Take care of the transition of the executions first, and then basically after that basically work our way through step by step. So